Is it feasible to colonize Alpha Centauri given today's technology? What if I told you that we possess just the right technology to take us to Alpha Centauri in less than 50 years? In an epoch where even going to Mars seems very hard, this statement might sound crazy, but trust me, it won't anymore after you watch this video. In 1958, the Orion Project started. It was guided by nuclear physicists Ted Taylor and Freeman Dyson. Their purpose? Building a nuclear-propelled rocket capable of sending a whole spaceship to Mars in a very short time, and to places like Alpha Centauri in less than a human lifetime. Unfortunately for space explorers, though, the Orion concept is inherently dirty because it uses fission fuel, and it also is very inefficient. A better mission concept would exploit fusion. However, while fission has been mastered and the technology required to build an Orion-type spaceship has existed for over 40 years now, no one has ever yet produced a properly controlled fusion energy. Nuclear propellant. Going to Alpha Centauri requires a means of propulsion very different than the ones we are used to. Nowadays, it is fairly easy to reach the Moon and other planets via low-thrust trajectories or via electric propulsion. From an efficiency point of view, these are for sure two of the best ways we have to explore the inner solar system. However, things become harder to deal with the further you go from Earth. Mars itself is hard to reach. Current plans to establish colonies on the red planet take months, if not years, for a spaceship to safely land on its surface. The typical amount of time is set to 9 months. Imagine the difficulty of such a mission. Astronauts would have to learn how to live in a very small environment altogether for 9 months straight. Needless to say, the physical and mental aspects of the problem seem a bit hard to overcome. Yet the scientific community is taking big steps, and we can safely say that one day, that dream will become a reality, and that might happen before you think. However, it is important to note that there may be a potential solution to reaching Mars in a much shorter time frame of around 2 months. I understand if you find it hard to believe, but allow me to provide an explanation. During the late 50s and early 60s, the US government supported a project named Orion, which had the potential to send expeditions to Mars and Saturn. Additionally, this project aimed to establish a lunar base with approximately 150 highly skilled scientists. The ideas and concepts developed during the 7-year duration of the project were remarkable and still hold significant merit in present times. Project Orion's concept was very cute, so to speak. The idea was to explode atomic bombs roughly 200 feet behind the vehicle in order to propel it and make it reach an enormous speed. The idea of an atomic drive, as Orion was a science fiction cliché by the 1930s. But in 1944, the first serious investigations were conducted in the framework of spaceflight. The basic idea behind all the nuclear propulsion engines that scientists were trying to build during those crazy times was to heat a working fluid by pumping it through a nuclear reactor. This would allow it to expand through a nozzle to develop thrust. Although this sounds simple, a lot of problems arose. But the prize of building an atomic-propelled spaceship would surpass every glory in the world and would have given much power to the country that first showed up with a working prototype. Such a motor would exploit the enormous power of the atomic bomb, estimated to be on the order of 10 billion horsepower. Bombs would be ejected backward from the vehicle, followed by solid propellant disks. The explosions would vaporize the disks, and the resulting plasma would impinge upon a pusher plate. The advantage of this system is that no attempt is made to confine the explosions, implying that relatively high yield, hence high power, bombs may be used. Such a system is neither temperature nor power limited. The calculated force exerted on the pusher plate was immense. It would have created intolerable acceleration for a manned vehicle itself. Therefore, a shock absorber system was placed between the plate and the vehicle itself. The durability of the plate was a major issue, but in the end, the experiments concluded that either aluminum or steel would be durable enough to act as plate material. Taylor and Dyson were developing plans for a manned journey through the solar system. The Orion design called for 2,000 pulse units, which would have provided enough thrust to escape Earth's gravity and possibly reach a cruise speed of 5% the speed of light, allowing humanity to reach for the stars. The vehicle would have been built like a battleship without the need for weight-saving measures used in other spacecraft. It is unclear how the Orion would have landed, but specialized chemically powered craft were likely to be used for exploration. The estimated cost of the 12-year program was $100 million per year, which may not have included all development costs. The Orion program would have likely relied on existing military and civilian space projects for support. Even if the cost estimate was off by a factor of 20, the revised total would still have been $24 billion, similar to the cost of the Apollo program. To thoroughly evaluate the feasibility of Project Orion, which relied on explosive nuclear reactions for propulsion, a series of tests were planned. These tests involved detonating small nuclear devices in the Earth's atmosphere, providing valuable data on the efficiency and capabilities of the proposed propulsion system. However, the era of atmospheric nuclear tests came to an abrupt halt due to international agreements during the Cold War. Concerns about the environmental and health consequences of radioactive fallout led to a ban on such tests. The Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, CTBT, negotiations played a pivotal role in shaping this global consensus, with major powers realizing the potential dangers posed by radioactive debris spreading through the atmosphere. It's important to note the distinction between atmospheric tests, which were banned due to the fallout risk, and underground testing. Even after the prohibition of atmospheric tests, underground nuclear testing continued for some time. This shift allowed nations to validate and improve their nuclear arsenals without the environmental repercussions associated with atmospheric detonations. This geopolitical context significantly impacted the fate of Project Orion. The cessation of atmospheric nuclear tests posed a significant obstacle to its development, ultimately leading to the project's cancellation in the 1960s. Despite the visionary ideas behind Orion's nuclear propulsion, geopolitical considerations and environmental concerns played a decisive role in shaping the destiny of this ambitious space exploration initiative. Alpha Centauri System. In theory, without the prohibition of nuclear tests and with proper attention to environmental and safety concerns, Project Orion had the potential for further development and utilization in space exploration, perhaps paving the way for interstellar travel. However, the practical application of this concept would necessitate a meticulous examination of issues such as environmental impact, safety measures, international cooperation, technological advancements, and ethical considerations. Nevertheless, this approach could potentially represent an existing technology to achieve travel to a new planetary system like Alpha Centauri. In case you did not know about this amazing star system, here's a brief overview. First of all, it is crucial to say that this is a triple star system, consisting of three stars named Alpha Centauri A, Alpha Centauri B, and Proxima Centauri. Proxima Centauri is the closest to our solar system. It's only 4.2 light years away from Earth. This star has received attention in the search for potentially habitable exoplanets, because some exoplanets were found orbiting around it. Proxima Centauri B, as one of these exoplanets is called, lies within the star's habitable zone, the region where conditions might allow for liquid water to exist. However, the habitability of Proxima Centauri B is still a subject of debate and research. Various factors, including the star's activity and the potential for tidal locking, need to be considered when assessing its suitability for life. Alpha Centauri A and B are both similar to our Sun, and they orbit each other in a relatively close binary system. Alpha Centauri A is a G2V-type star with a mass slightly larger than the Sun, with a radius and luminosity also slightly larger than our star. Alpha Centauri B is a K1V-type star, slightly cooler and less massive than its companion. Both stars' temperature ranges between 5,260 and 5,790 Kelvin. For comparison, the temperature of the Sun is around 5,772 Kelvin. Both Alpha Centauri A and B have been subjects of interest in the search for potentially habitable exoplanets. However, no confirmed Earth-like planets in the habitable zone of either star have been discovered so far. Exploring Alpha Centauri to uncover the mysteries within this star system holds profound implications. This leads us to ponder, what would the journey be like if we could propel ourselves there using a system akin to the one envisioned by Project Orion? Feasibility. Imagine the scenario. Alpha Centauri is an immense distance of 25.6 trillion miles away. Now, what if we were determined to send a space probe there by the year 2120? To calculate the time required for such a journey, we subtract the current year, 2024, from the target year, 2120, which amounts to 96 years. In terms of hours, this equates to a staggering 840,960 hours. In order to accomplish our goal, we would need a spacecraft capable of maintaining an average speed of 30,441,400.3 miles per hour, which is roughly 4.5% of the speed of light. During the preliminary stages of Project Orion, Dyson extensively analyzed the possibilities. He concluded that it would indeed be feasible to propel a spacecraft to approximately 5% of the speed of light. Considering our aim is to achieve 4% of the speed of light, and given Dyson's assertion of reaching 5%, one can logically infer that it is theoretically possible to reach Alpha Centauri within a single human lifespan. Crazy, right? Breakthrough Starshot. Project Orion is not the only initiative aiming for the stars. Enter Breakthrough Starshot, a bold venture backed by Russian billionaire Yuri Milner. Launched some years ago, this project has reignited the dream of exploring nearby star systems. The Breakthrough Starshot team wants to send nanospacecraft to our closest neighbor, hurtling at an astonishing 20% of the speed of light. This would allow humanity to reach Alpha Centauri within a mere 20 years. Inspired by the Starshot concept, scientists at the Max Planck Institute in Germany have proposed a groundbreaking method to slow down the spacecraft once it arrives at its destination. This is achieved using stellar pressure, a crucial element if the spacecraft is to capture images or gather scientific data upon arrival. But that's not all. A new player has entered the cosmic stage, courtesy of NASA. This project is named a Breakthrough Propulsion Architecture for Interstellar Precursor Missions. As part of NASA's Advanced Concepts program, this study explores the use of lasers to transmit power across the solar system, mirroring the Breakthrough Starshot concept. The proposed architecture also includes a highly efficient solar photovoltaic array, boasting an impressive 60 to 70% efficiency, along with a lithium-based ion propulsion system. These projects collectively showcase the renewed interest in interstellar exploration. Breakthrough Starshot and NASA's Advanced Propulsion Architecture Project are among the pioneers pushing the boundaries of what's possible, bringing us one step closer to the dream of reaching and exploring other star systems. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Fusion propulsion. Another more efficient way to reach for the stars is nuclear fusion propulsion. At the heart of nuclear fusion lies the quest to replicate the conditions of the Sun, extreme temperatures, and pressures that can force atomic nuclei to combine. This demand for controlled high-temperature plasma, where fusion reactions occur, necessitates innovative methods of confinement, each with its set of stability and containment challenges. The overarching challenge extends beyond sustaining fusion reactions to achieving a net positive energy output. Ensuring that the energy release surpasses the input required to sustain the reaction is a critical criterion for the practical viability of fusion as an energy source. Material science presents a formidable challenge as well. The harsh conditions within a fusion reactor, high temperatures and neutron flux, demand materials capable of withstanding prolonged exposure without degradation. This requirement adds a layer of complexity to the engineering and design of fusion reactors. As we wrap up this video, let's pause and reflect on the myriad of possibilities that technology is unveiling before us. With these opportunities in view, the prospect of reaching Alpha Centauri doesn't appear as distant as one might think, does it? That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you think we will ever be able to reach the Alpha Centauri system? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.